Ladies and gentlemen, the Backyard Wrestling community is proud to present the best of the best coming from all around Indiana. But only one will be invading Indiana.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Invading Indiana. We are here on all the different channels. I'm here in the commentary booth. My name is Mags, and I am joined by the one, the only...
You know what? I'm a busy man.
Wow. I was just going to get ready to say my thing. And
fucking jackass, man. Interrupting commentary? What kind of dipshit does that?
And I don't know who it is, really, that's invading Indiana. It could be someone from Minnesota, Missouri, MEBW, BWF, SBW, BYW. BYWE, SWE, all these different companies. It could be anyone, and I don't know who it is. But it is my responsibility as UAW World Heavyweight Champion, CBW Chaos Champion, VCW Anarchy Champion.
A lot of champions.
Make sure the show.
He does hold many belts.
Bang. Bang, bang, bang. So, you may be wondering how I'm going to do that. You may be wondering what I'm going to do to make sure that happens. Oh, ladies and gentlemen. This was originally supposed to be a three-night event, but you know, it's just too good for three nights. That would draw it out. So we're going to put it all in one night. One show. And that show is going to feature multiple matches with multiple people. But one of the matches y'all need to watch out for is the UAW World Heavyweight Championship Open Challenge. See, I'm calling out whoever it is that's invading Indiana, because this is my state, this is my home turf, and no one's gonna invade it and not have to go through me first. So whoever you are, you just know, you got yourself a UAW World Heavyweight Championship match, and well, I'm gonna make you go night-night, bitch.
Captain Law calling out whoever's invading Indiana, and he's going to give them a UAW World Championship match. And from what I'm being told, this is starting the show tonight.
What an opener.
So I guess we're going to find out who's invading Indiana a lot sooner than we may have thought. In fact, here's the music of Captain Law. This show is underway, folks.
What an opener. We're going to start this show off with a, no pun intended, but bang bang.
Indeed we are, Riley, and you gotta wonder why the production booth sent a commentator from SBW to commentate with me from UAW VGW. We were both just sent the link and told to commentate. I gotta wonder if they made that choice on purpose or if they made that choice on their own. And they're like,
yeah.
Well,
yeah, well, we're just going to have to find out. I got to wonder, though. Well, never mind. Here we go again.
Tonight,
being cut off once more.
You heard me call out whoever it is that's invading Indiana to catch this lightning of my fucking power. And you know what? I said I'd put the UAW World Heavyweight Championship on the line as such. So, who's ever invading Indiana, prepare to get invaded.
Captain Law calling out who's ever invading Indiana. Who do you think it's going to be, Riley?
Well, I hear a drum. I hear a snare. I recognize this music. Do you?
I it's familiar to me. Oh my God! It's the Invader.
It is Kurt Adams, the so-called sexy bearded guy. Ladies and gentlemen, Kurt Adams is a former SBW Interstate Champion, former BWF Interstate Champion, former BWF YouTube Champion. This man has a lot of titles and a lot of different things on his resume.
And Captain Law is shocked. This is someone he thought he'd get to work with and never thought he'd get to work against, let alone right here, right now, at Invading Indiana.
Few long years.
Oh, shit.
Waiting for this time. 2 long years. Waiting for this, and guess what? As much as a shock factor will be, this is, after I kick your ass, there will be no apologies and no resurrection for your career.
Captain Law telling him there's going to be no resurrection for his career. Title ring. And title Kurt's giving it right back to him.
Oh.
Fuck off me, bitch.
Kurt tried to start off strong, and he catches him with a super kick, and down goes the champ.
And ladies and gentlemen, Kurt Adams going for the pin and a kick out of two.
One more. Only a two count, and Captain Law getting caught off guard here. Kurt Adams with another strong super kick. Now, Riley, last time we saw Captain Law in a UAW World Championship match and it was an open challenge, he didn't walk away with the title.
Why?
You got to wonder if that's going to be the same outcome here tonight.
Well, you got to think for Captain Law here, he does not want that outcome to happen because he just won, I guess, the UAW World Championship. And if you were a champion, you don't want to lose it this quickly in your title reign.
Especially since this is his first defense since winning it at UAW War Games.
And Kurt Adams setting for something big here. What could he be looking for?
Getting that running start.
Oh my lord, what a forearm.
Captain Law told him to ride the lightning and just tossing him down, tilt-a-whirl style. Looked like a modified crossroads, but he didn't follow through on it, so I guess we'll call it the crossfade.
Kurt Adams looking like a... I don't know, what do you call it?
looking Captain like Law's a, got that light tube, though, that Kurt brought out with him.
Broke it. That's 50 shades of light tube there. Oh my god!
The back was exposed, too.
Kurt Adams, man. What a big kick.
That's my thing, you piece of shit.
Running drop kick now laying into him. Kurt Adams, one of the most skilled workers with his feet from South Dakota.
And ladies and gentlemen, the light tube smashed over some part of that jacket, over that flannel, and he's choking Captain Lion with it.
You've got the light tube seemed to not even faze Kurt. It just made him angry.
Well, you know, I've been hit with a light tube. As I say that, Kurt Adams hits it to Dunzo to Captain Law. But like I said, I've been hit with a light tube, and I've been given light tube hits. And let me tell you, they are not fun at all.
Now, I as Mags have not had the pleasure. Oh, Captain Law catching Kurt on the bridge of the nose. That could have smashed his nose open.
This could be a UFC fight here.
Mine.
And now, Captain Law.
Mine.
Not face Owen and Enziguri. Catching Captain Law on the jaw. And a big kick to the stomach. And stunner.
Stunner.
Someone call Austin 316 and just say, oh, hell yeah.
One, two.
Kurt going for the pin off of it. Only a two count. Captain Law kicks out. Kurt transitioning well, using his technical ability, taking it right into a side headlock. And Captain Law stands up out of it and back body drop.
Ow, fuck my arm.
Sends Kurt reeling, but Captain Law's got to be weary. He's already complaining about pains in his arm. He's had both of his arms broken before, so...
And ladies and gentlemen, sorry to cut you off, but ladies and gentlemen, Captain Law has the belt. What's he going to do? Oh! Kurt Adams ducks it. Super kick!
Captain Law's down again.
Oh, stomping on the back does Kurt Adams. And ladies and gentlemen...
I think Captain Law's head hit the title.
One, two.
And ladies and gentlemen, sorry, I keep cutting you off. You're the thing of UAW here, so I'll let you. You do you.
Kurt followed it up with an elbow drop, and again, sorry, I'm also cutting you off, but I'm just too excited for this.
Fuck you, and
this is a shock and a half to see Kurt Adams in a UAW championship match.
Ladies and gentlemen, I didn't think Kurt Adams would come here, honestly. I think we see somebody like Gunshot. Oh! Belt to face.
Clocks him straight in the mush, and if the shot to his face earlier didn't break his nose, that certainly would have.
Look at this.
Probably blood? Could see some blood.
Captain Law raking the eyes now.
Where the fuck is back?
Captain Law asking where the hell his bat is.
As I was saying, though, before that action happened, we didn't know it was going to be Kurt Adams. Oh, my God. The bat across the stomach and now across the spine.
That bat is laced with barbed wire, and he's grinding it on the forehead of Kurt Adams.
Oh, good. That does not. Oh, I've been also hit with a barbed wire object. It was bamboo, by the way. I have not been hit by one, but I have given this man right here, Kurt Adams, a barbed wire bamboo on the back.
And Captain Law follows the baseball bat shot to the top of the head with a pin. The pin was very lackadaisical. You got to think maybe Captain Law would have had the victory if he'd have actually fully covered it.
Yeah. Kurt Adams, I think, is trying to look for a collar and elbow tie up here.
A little late in the match for a collar and elbow. Oh, and he faked him out.
And Kurt Adams looking for a sleeper hold here. If he can just get it in, he can get him with a rear naked choke.
Captain Law not used to someone with this technical ability.
Oh.
Backpack stunner!
Good God, I have not seen this out of Captain Law or Kurt Adams here tonight.
I need some more weapons.
These two bringing their all. Captain Law calling for more weapons. But he's walking with a bit of a stumble. You can obviously tell that this is taking a toll on him.
Yeah.
Both physically.
So you know what? I think I'm going to drive your head into the ground.
A golf club. Oh, the curtain.
And wait. Oh, what a kick. Right to the side of the head and out to the side of the face. Right to the cheek. Captain Law could be unconscious here.
And Kurt making him taste the South Dakotan soil. They don't call him the South Dakota Super Kick King for nothing. But Captain Law catches him with a punch to the gut and throws him into that brush pile.
You have to be wondering what's in the brush pile. It could be barbed wire. It could be thumbtacks. Hell, it could be. It could be friggin'.
Whatever it is, Kurt found one and just broke a thick old stick over the back of Captain Law.
Like a motherfucker!
Snapping it up. Oh my God! Just stabbing him straight into the heart.
One.
And then stomping on the wound.
Ladies and gentlemen, we might need some ER here in this match.
Indeed, but you got to think, if that stick was sharp, it would have pierced the skin, but I think it just bruised Captain Law's lungs because he's having a lot of trouble breathing.
Yeah, and now, ladies and gentlemen, Kurt Adams with a one-legged Boston crab.
Do you tap?
Again, takes a big man down and he can't fight. He'd be a one-legged man in an ass-kicking contest.
Fuck good boy.
Oh, the disrespect. Captain Law just spitting in the face of Kurt Adams.
I know what it's like to spit in the face of Kurt Adams, and let me tell you, it is not a clever idea.
Captain Law getting back to his feet. Kurt spit in his own hand. Oh, and just smacked Captain Law across the face with it.
Wait a minute. Kurt Adams now going to get something. Captain Law, I think he might be dazed, ladies and gentlemen. Now, I gotta wonder, because SBW title rules and UAW title rules are different. Are weapons allowed in this?
Yes, we're going by UAW rules here, which means there are no rules, but that golf club that Captain Law was using there is bent in half. He bent it over the sternum of Kurt Adams before grinding that glass into his forehead. That solid steel golf club.
You know what? By the way,
the amount of force Captain Law would have had to use to bend that over Kurt Adams' sternum.
What is? Do
you
Captain tap? Law with the walls of Jericho, or a Boston crab, it looks like, to Kurt Adams. And Kurt Adams now is. Oh, I thought.
Wrenching it back in.
I thought Kurt Adams was given some momentum here. And ladies and gentlemen, Kurt Adams could be done. Kurt Adams could be done.
Ref picking up the arm. Hit him twice.
Two.
Fuck off.
Oh.
Captain Law, not wanting it to end that way, told the referee to fuck right off. I think he could have had him knocked out there.
Goes for the pin here. One, two.
Oh my God.
No!
Another lackadaisical cover, and it cost Captain Law the pinfall. Imagine if he'd have hooked the leg and centered his weight right there. He probably could have had it.
And ladies and gentlemen, I'm wondering how the hell Kurt Adams has been able to kick out of all that. And again, off the back with the barbed wire bat.
And right to the side of the head and into the gut. Captain Law is sinking him in deep.
What could happen here?
Oh, package pile driver, no! Kurt rolled through!
What?
Kurt rolled through on the package pile driver. Caught him with a pinfall. And now a fury of kicks to the back.
No.
And another dunzo to Captain Law. Ladies and gentlemen, if Kurt Adams hit Captain Law with the Pyramid Buster here tonight, this could be all over, folks.
But you gotta wonder, is Kurt gonna be able to pick Pyramid the big man up for the Pyramid Buster?
And he's gonna, really? And he's trying to pick him up, but it isn't phasing. It isn't phasing Captain Law here.
Kurt, obviously hurting his back. Oh, Captain Law with a shot to the gut, now picking him up on his shoulders.
Oh my God, what could happen here? What could we be seeing here?
Attitude adjustment. Onto the barbed wire bat.
Oh my God.
One, two, three. Oh, he didn't get the
hit. No. Kurt Adams kicks out once more, ladies and gentlemen.
He's still in.
Who is going to win this match?
2 3/4, and Kurt kicked out of the attitude adjustment onto the bat. Kick to the gut.
Give me the beat, boys.
He's got him in position.
I want to get lost in your rock and roll and drift away.
And a drift away.
One. Two, three.
Captain Law retains.
What a match, ladies and gentlemen. What a match.
Captain Law able to get the three count over the Invader. You gotta wonder, though, if this will boost the ego of Captain Law.
Oh.
What is this? From behind, Caden. And Nico Vibe out of nowhere from behind. Running in and attacking Captain Law. Now it looks like they're going after Kurt Adams. No, they just tossed Kurt to the side, and the former UAW champion, Caden, grabbing
Holy
the belt.
Fuck.
And Nico Vibe laying in shots onto Captain Law.
No.
Nico Vibe. Nico Vibe locking in an arm bar. Now Caden locking in one of his own.
What in the blue balls hell is going on here?
An oddball tag team. Kurt, though, is going to help. He is! Kurt coming to the aid of the fat man! With a big double stomp on the Nico Vibe. Riley, you know Kurt all too well. Is this something he usually does? Does he help? Like this?
No. No, he doesn't. When I met him, no, he doesn't. Oh, and Captain Law with the barbed wire bat through the stomach and the face and the back. Ladies and gentlemen, this is just pandemonium.
Nico Vibe down on the ground. Now Kurt laying into him with the baseball bat. Now Captain Law over there attacking Caden.
Get out of here. Get out of here.
Kurt telling Nico to get out of here. And now going after Caden.
Ladies and gentlemen, you could wonder if this could set up for a future tag match between Kurt Adams and Captain Law versus Caden effing Batana and Nico
Captain Law saying, tomorrow night, for obviously forgetting that Invading Indiana has been rescinded to a one-night exclusive event.
Fucked up.
calling out for a tag team match, and apparently it's going to happen. And from what I am being told by the production booth, Riley, the match is going to happen next. What is this? Why is Captain Long Caden talking?
He's been the best hardcore champion. He couldn't make it because he's actually an athlete. By default.
Caden with the CXG Hardcore Championship. What is he going to do? He puts the belt on Captain Law.
Yeah, boys.
CXG Once again, champ. CXG Hardcore time. Champion is Captain Law. But who's ever mind? Oh, a low blow.
And ladies and gentlemen, is that Gunshot? Yeah.
You wanna come in that and is.
Still my chaos health. Let's go play that game, bitch. Now, your new
ladies Gunshot. And gentlemen.
Hardcore champion.
Another superstar from Indiana, but I'm at a loss for words, and Caden attacking Gunny.
What in the blue balls is going on here? What in damn hell?
I don't know what we just saw, but apparently Gunshot's the new CXG Hardcore Champion, but what a way to follow that up is with Kurt Adams and Captain Law, the fuck-ups, taking on Caden and Nyko Vibe. You gotta wonder if Caden set Captain Law up right there.
You gotta wonder.
And this music can only mean one thing.
What the fuck?
The fuck-ups, Kurt Adams and Captain Law.
Fuck up.
One night only, I guess. Working together here.
You gotta wonder, though, if Captain Law is going to betray Kurt Adams here, he could have hit him with an electric chair drop.
He could have, but it looks like they're on the same page. But you gotta wonder if the oddball team of Nyko Vibe and Caden are also on the same page.
Yes, you do. And ladies and gentlemen, here comes Nyko Vibe.
And you gotta think though, Captain Law and Kurt Adams came out together as a unified team. Nyko Vibe's not with his partner. His partner's nowhere to be seen.
Where's my tag team?
But and Nyko Vibe asking where his tag partner is, but right there he is.
Some partner here.
The Wolf of War, Caden Ratana.
Straight disrespectful to UAW. Look at that.
As the cameraman said, being disrespectful to UAW, coming out here wearing the UAW logo on his ass.
Sorry, not being disrespectful to UAW, but I thought it's kind of funny.
I find it extremely disrespectful. You got to wonder if that's going to cost him, though, because his tag partner is the co-owner of UAW, Nyko Vibe.
That is true. Ladies and gentlemen, by the looks of it, this match is going to take place right here, right now, when the bell rings.
These two conferencing with their tag team partners. Obviously trying to decide who's coming out first, and it looks like it's going to start off. But Caden tags himself in. It was going to start off Captain Law and Nyko Vibe, a storied rivalry.
But I think Caden wanted Captain Law. And now, ladies and gentlemen, Captain Law tagging in Kurt Adams. And these two going to go for a collar and elbow tie up here. And Caden with the headlock applied to Kurt Adams here.
Now, these two have never worked explicitly together before. Oh, and Kurt Adams sends Caden into a clothesline. But Caden is known to be Kurt Adams' quote-unquote side project. He's helped him. Oh, Captain Law catching his partner. Oh, and he gets a kick to the back from Caden. This tag team match is slowly breaking down into chaos here.
Caden with a super kick to Kurt Adams. And then Captain Law with a super kick to Caden, and now it looked like Nyko Vibe, but with a Superman punch to Kurt Adams here.
This match is boiling down into chaos, and there's just no way to keep track of what's going on here.
So it looks like
taking Captain Law, or looks Kurt Adams on a walk.
It looks like these four men could be the four members of Retribution.
It could be, and they're They're going out towards the street. This is quickly turning into an Indiana street fight. You got to wonder if Caden's has malicious intent here, right there by the street. Could be thinking to throw Kurt into the traffic.
You also got to wonder, though, if Kurt could do the same thing by reversing it here. But ladies and gentlemen, you got to wonder, what is Nykel Vibe and Captain Lott doing?
But as of everyone else, a wolf's journey, but didn't take Kurt down. But Kurt is the only one here who isn't used to that Indiana traffic. He doesn't know how to weave his way through it. So if he gets thrown into that street, it could be detrimental to his entire life.
And ladies and gentlemen,
Caden on top of the car, and the fans in the background, the civilians wandering down the street, are cheering on Kurt, telling him to get back into it, and Caden off the top of the car with a double axe handle.
My lord, what a jump. And what a move.
And here comes Captain Law back into it. You gotta wonder if him and Nykel Vibe were brawling this entire time. And a big running boot.
You gotta wonder if Captain Law will be the adult and take Caden, Evan, Retainer down that slide in the background.
Definitely. The background there is a child care center, so you gotta wonder if maybe he'll throw Caden over that fence. And but Nyko coming out of nowhere to help his partner. These four are brawling. I don't even know who the legal man is anymore.
Ladies and gentlemen, this could be a... if both teams start turning on each other, this could be a fatal four-way here. But like you said, Max, this is turning into one fucking duckle chaos.
Indeed, these two men, four men going after each other, Captain Law throwing Kurt into Caden. And these four men are just boiling down into chaos. I mean, call this AEW, because this tag team match is just boiled down into an all-out free-for-all. Now, we're getting back into the main arena here, but Captain Law and Nygo Vibe attacking each other now.
You gotta wonder if they're... As you're saying?
I was saying Kurt was standing there waiting for Caden, because I believe Kurt and Caden are the legal men. Oh, a steel pipe to the chest!
I was gonna say, you gotta wonder if the damage by Caden to Kurt Adams will affect him in this match.
And it may do just that. Kurt saying he wants Caden. Caden tagging Nyko Vibe back in.
Ladies and gentlemen, you gotta wonder if Caden is using Nyko here to be more healthy in this match. What a punch!
Nyko with a Superman punch, taking his own tag team partner down. And now the camera's back. Kurt just hit Caden with his own move!
My lord, a wolf's journey by Kurt Adams to Caden Ratana. You gotta wonder. Oh, wait, what in the world?
A big splash!
This could be it. 2, 3.
And that's it.
Gentlemen, this match is over. Your winners, Kurt Adams and Captain Law.
The BYW fuck ups. Strong again, and what a way to follow that up, except with another UAW championship match here, the Riot Championship on the line to crown the first ever UAW champion.
Let's bring out the first competitor in the gauntlet match.
In this gauntlet match, who's the first competitor gonna be?
It's Captain Law, three belts, the VCW Anarchy Champion, the UAW World Champion, and the CBW Chaos Champion.
Captain Law coming out for his third match in a row. But then again, remember, these were supposed to be three different nights. So
wrapping his own heart, too.
If the other two matches have taken a toll on Captain Law.
And I am the most legendary.
Hold on, I'll be right back. I gotta go do something.
Fuck Jake Cage. Fuck Joe Wolf.
And Captain Law,
fuck Jay the Key
coming
Evans.
Out representing
I am
VCW,
legend.
UAW, and
wait for it.
CBW as Derek. The Chaos Champion, even though
now,
that title is no longer
who's Drew number two?
Around.
Let's bring out the second competitor in the gauntlet match.
That title has been retired and is now the Critical Backyard Wrestling Turmoil Championship.
Oh boy, this is a big one. The CBW YouTube Champion and CXG World Champion, Kaden.
Number two, the CBW YouTube Champion and CXG World Heavyweight Champion, the Wolf of War. Kaden Ratana. Again, Captain Law and Kaden with a long, storied history here.
Again? Son of a twat.
Really? Captain Law just as surprised as anybody else to see Kaden here.
And what?
And of course, Captain Law bringing up the fact that he beat Kaden at War Games to take home the UAW World Heavyweight Championship.
Oh, but you know what's going to happen? I'm going to take yet another title from you. Another opportunity.
Think you're better than
and then you know what?
And you got to wonder if that'll be the same result here tonight, if Captain Law will be able to
and I'm coming
take out Kaden Ratana
I'm gonna be Captain All
and stop him from becoming UAW Riot Champion. Kaden, though, on his... And Captain Law catches him with a kick and a knee to start this match. Captain Law ducking out of what looked to be a trouble in paradise from Kaden.
You're not my bitch, huh?
No.
If you want the spell back, you stop right there.
Captain Law holding Caden's titles, taunting and teasing him, and just chucks the CXG title at Kaden. Throws the YouTube title off the side, and these two are brawling now. Kaden catching Captain Law with a super kick, again taking the big man down, and now with a jumping knee, catching him square in the gut. These two going at it hot and heavy, folks. Captain Law catching Kaden, saw him coming and caught his leg and tripped him up. Captain Law with a super kick of his own.
Get up, you fucker.
Crumpling Kaden down. Kaden and Captain Law now going after each other. Captain Law ripping off the bandana of Kaden Ratana and beating him with it.
Hey. Fuck
what disrespect. And now Captain Law wiping his ass with Caden's bandana. What disrespect from Captain Law to Kaden Ratana. Now picking Kaden up. Looking to cinch him in for the drift away. Can he hit it? Spinning him around. And he almost hit it, but Kaden reversed it into a stunner. Kaden obviously doing his homework on Captain Law, because Captain Law did not have that in his arsenal last time the two of them faced. So Kaden has obviously been paying attention to some of Captain Law's work.
And he could be studying Captain Law before this gauntlet match.
Indeed he could be. Welcome back to the production booth, Riley.
Yeah.
Captain Law now getting back to his feet. Kaden with a big kick to the shoulder area. And one to the back and a knee to the side of the face. But Captain Law spider walking now. Channeling his inner Bray Wyatt.
I was just going to say, who knew that Captain Law was Bray Wyatt all along? He just needs his sister Abigail, and Kaden was going to go for an enziguri, but Captain Law caught the leg.
Again, these two know each other so well. Kaden with that high-flying style and dropping the knee into the ground.
And ladies and gentlemen, Kaden, I'm guessing reversed whatever that foot DDT and... Not going to choke out Captain Law here.
But Captain Law spinning him out, able to grab the arm and turn it into a rear naked choke. Good night. Telling Kaden to go night-night, but he didn't follow through with it and didn't drop all of his weight down and lock the legs. And Kaden was able to catch him with a kick. Went for another one of those enziguris, but Captain Law catches the leg.
He catches it once more, and you got to wonder... If Captain Law is trying to break the ankle, and ladies and gentlemen, oh, what a kick by Captain Law to Kaden.
Catches him square on the jaw. These two with a long storied history, Captain Law taking the world title back from Kaden. And there must be a ruckus backstage because it distracted them both, but now they're trading blows once again.
You can't have that during a gauntlet match. You can't have a ruckus or distraction distracting you in a gauntlet match. Trust me, I know from experience. We've had one at One Versus All, a One Versus All gauntlet match. You should go check it out. Sorry for the shameless plug. But you cannot be distracted. You have to be focused. You have to be ready for anything. And when the time comes,
I'm sorry to cut you.
No, you're all right.
Sorry to cut you off, but Caden just with a running basement drop kick, crumpling the big man again. Caden, that high flying style. That's why Captain Hall was working on the legs.
Wolf's journey.
What a wolf's journey.
One,
to Catalan. This could be it.
Three.
Goes for the pin. Two, three. And ladies and gentlemen, Caden winning the first gauntlet match.
Adams, I think, is the next person in the gauntlet
Caden
match.
Calling Kurt Adams out to be the third participant. Will Kurt accept it?
And ladies and gentlemen, here comes Kurt Adams.
Kurt obviously accepting to be the third participant. And after Kurt beat Caden with his own move, you gotta think Caden is furious. And obviously, these two have some type of feelings towards each other because they are going at each other hard.
And ladies and gentlemen, as I was saying before, you gotta be focused on this. Kurt Adams being somebody that Caden has, like, respected over the social media and is willing to face, him not knowing that Kurt Adams was the third entrant could have messed up Caden's mindset going into this gauntlet match.
It could have, but we've seen a more sadistic style of Kurt Adams here, attacking the limbs and targeting past injuries of each opponent. Kurt Adams is bringing everything he's got against his opponents.
And what a knee scraping the side of the face by Caden Ratana. But you gotta know, though, Caden had those kick pads, Kurt Adams doesn't. So that's a little protection to Kurt.
Caden getting a drink and then throwing the drink cup at the top of Kurt's head and then catching him with a super kick. But Kurt turns it around into a big enziguri.
What an enziguri by Kurt Adams. You know, that man is also like a mystery box from Super Mario Kart. He has almost anything he puts his mind to, he can do it and will do it. And now, ladies and gentlemen, these two are going back and forth with shots, chops, and hell, even a dick block.
These two are going at each other hard and heavy, trading chops and punches to one another. And both people are back on their feet. And a double clothesline.
My lord. These are like watching two cruiserweights, like watching Sonic the Hedgehog and Tails. There we go. Watching Sonic the Hedgehog and Tails run around each other.
And hide your kids and hide your wives because Kurt's attacking him with his head.
And ladies and gentlemen, both kick up. And these two getting ready for something. What could they be doing here?
At a stalemate, and Caden with a running knee lift to the chest of Kurt Adams. And Kurt with a running knee strike of his own. Shades of Daniel Bryan there.
Ladies and gentlemen, Kurt slithering, crawling by his hands and knees, going over to Caden now. And ladies and gentlemen, Kurt with a punch to Caden, and now these two again going back and forth. You gotta wonder, will this affect them both at all? And the skill of a gauntlet match is to not keep the match going forever and ever. You want to eliminate as many people as you can and keep moving forward.
Exactly. These two are, in my opinion, exerting too much energy and could potentially cost them the next round should they move forward. But Kurt looking to get a running start for something. What's he going for? Caden catches him with a wolf's journey.
This could be it. Two. No, Kurt Adams kicks out at the brink of three.
And you
I'll
know
be
what
back
we call
once more. I'm sorry. I'll that, be back once we, more.
We call that wolf's journey the RKO of the backyard because Caden can hit it anywhere, and Caden catching him with a knee to the back. These two may not know each other, but they've studied each other. They haven't never faced, but they're given everything each other do, the other has a response for. And Caden grabbing the UAW world title out of that pile of belts. A title that Caden holds in high regard. It was the first championship he won outside of CXG. And a curb stomp onto the UAW World Championship. But Kurt isn't down, and Caden catches him with what I think was a clothesline, but the camera didn't quite pick it up. Now Caden picking up Kurt. And Kurt catching him with a glancing enziguri, but it was enough to take him down. But I don't think he got every bit of that. Now mounting him with some fury offense here. Kurt trying to figure out what he's got to do to keep Caden down. And Caden, quite the same. Caden with a big punch and then a kick to the side of the chest with a bit of an enziguri of his own. Again, both men are down.
One, two.
And now Caden trading blows, but Kurt catches him with a pin. Only a two count, though. Caden and Kurt giving each other their all. Caden catching Kurt with a knee and now walking the dog, throwing him like a rag doll. Kurt just rolls through. Kurt stumbling, though. Again, heading out of the main arena, and Kurt catching Caden with a super kick, and Caden catching him with a kick to the gut of his own, and now a strike to the back of the head, and he's walking him once again. Caden taking Kurt where he wants to go. Once again, no longer in the, I guess, ring per se, outside of the starting area of this match. But Caden and Kurt heading over towards that old rusty park equipment. Caden catching Kurt with a big clothesline there, sending him down. And now tossing him over that pole in the ground. These two given that they're all, folks, and I don't know what Caden's got planned here, but dragging him over to the ladder and Caden climbing up the ladder. Caden again, that spider monkey style on the ladder. You got to wonder what he's going to do. Double axe handle to the top of the head off the ladder. And that one took Kurt down for sure. Caden now picking Kurt up, dragging him over to the slide. What's he going to do? Bashes his head against the side of the slide. These two not holding anything back, using their entire environment. And again, hitting Kurt's head off of the slide. Caden now climbing to the top of the ladder, but Kurt looking to meet him up there. Kurt starts kicking Caden. Caden's on his way down. Oh, and kicks Caden off the ladder. Kurt saying he's on top of the world. Now getting in prime position. What's he looking for? A double axe handle of his own. Taking down Caden Ratana, taking out the Wolf of War. These two got to get back to the main staging arena. Oh, and Kurt pushes Caden into the slide. Caden turns it around with a kick of his own. And then a forearm strike to the back. Caden trying to recuperate himself here. This long and grueling match.
Now we're going over the slide.
Caden throwing Kurt over the slide, but Kurt's catching himself on his feet and a big super kick. But I don't think Kurt got all of it because Caden did not go down. Kurt now running back towards the main area where the matches are going, and Caden trying to run after him. Caden stumbles and trips, Shockmaster style. Ladies and gentlemen, Caden trying to get his bearings back after that stumble. Kurt dazed, and Caden finally catches up to him. And Caden dragging Kurt back to the main area. The cameraman trying to catch up to him here. These two going at it hot and heavy. in a definite long and grueling match, and Caden catches Kurt with something. I couldn't quite tell what it was. But now picking up Kurt's head and just dropping a fist into it. Caden now picking Kurt up. Super kick! And Caden has Kurt up on his shoulders. What's he going for here? A pyramid buster! Turnabout's fair play. Kurt pinned Caden with the Wolf's Journey, but can Caden get the pin?
A few moments
later. Caden gets the pin.
We are here with Kurt Adams.
And a few moments later,
the next round of the Gauntlet match. We are here to get a few words with Kurt Adams after
taking a brief intermission here.
Getting pinned by Caden.
To beat me is one thing. To be my side project that I built from the ground up. I built from the ground up. I helped him get everywhere he has gotten in backyard wrestling. He is the only reason that I exist, that he exists right now. To beat me is one thing. One thing. But to beat me with my own finisher. I knew you had gotten cocky, kid, but I didn't think it was this bad. And it looks like old Doc's gonna have to put you down. One last time. So, Caden, one-on-one. Midnight Madness match. You and me. And if you think any match has been prestigious enough for you, Kurt's out here.
Holy hell, it's the BWF YouTube Championship!
This is from SBW.
Kurt calling Caden out for a match here.
Blue Powers
at Invading Indiana. Probably going to be the main event, a Midnight Madness match for the BWF YouTube Championship. I guess we'll find out later if Caden accepts it, but we're back out to the arena here. And the fourth entrant is Blue Power Skull. Blue Power Skull, a BWF competitor, much like Kurt Adams, but he's given the work here to Caden. Stomping that knee down into the ground. Blue Power Skull really putting the work here on Caden, but Caden exerted himself a little too much in that match against Kurt and didn't leave much energy, as you can tell, for Blue Power Skull. Now a half Boston Crab here. Locked in the leg on Caden. Could this be the end of Caden's run here in the Riot Gauntlet match? Caden looking to get another UAW championship so he can option C cash it in to become UAW world champion, but Blue Power Skull is so far blocking Caden's attempts at it. Caden down on the ground. Blue Power Skull beating him in the head. A little bit of trash talking and a running stomp right to the shoulder blade of Caden, sending him down into the ground. Caden is down and Kurt is picking him up. Could he be looking for the skull crushing finale? He's got him in position for it. Skull crushing finale, and down goes Caden. Blue Power Skull only getting a two count out of it, though. Caden fighting to stay in this match. Third opponent here in the Gauntlet match. Caden making it through two others. Can he make it through the third? I don't think so, going off of how it looks right now. Blue Power Skull is giving it all to Caden and giving him every bit of his effort, and Caden is managing to fight back. Just now getting to his feet, and Blue Power Skull disrespectful in his ways, just kicking Caden around like a rag doll. Getting a running start. What is Blue Power Skull going for here? Went for a running boot, but Caden sidesteps him. This could be Caden's only opportunity to gain a little momentum. And a big shining wizard style kick to Blue Power Skull's face. Caden hooks him. Whoops, Journey! Dropping him right on his skull, right on the cold, hard Indiana ground. One. 2 3/4, but Blue Power Skull catches him with a roll-up. Only getting a one count. Blue Power Skull using a little bit of his effort there. You gotta wonder if that's all that was left in the tank for Blue Power Skull. Caden now adding insult to injury, throwing his elbow pad at Blue Power Skull. Power Skull trying to fight back into this here. Trying to pick Caden up and drag him over to him. Now Blue Power Skull with a shot, and Caden with one of his own. These two are trading blows here. Trying to fight back to their feet. Caden catches him with a big kick right to the face. Almost a sit-out insiguri. Blue Power Skull just now trying to fight back, though. These two trading shots. Caden catches him in the nutsack. Caden nipping him in the nuts. Again, this is a UAW championship, so there are no rules. And a super kick telling him he's going to take
one,
his skull off.
Two. One.
Caden trying to roll him up there. Only a two count. Another one. Only a one count, though. Caden now with a clothesline, sending Blue Power Skull down and out. You got to begin to wonder if Blue Power Skull underestimated Caden's ability here to continue after all these matches. Caden now looking to take the wrist tape off. I don't know what he's doing with it, but he's stuffing it into the face of Blue Power Skull, and he punches it into the face. Just a little extra insult
to
injury. And
two,
another Wolf's Journey.
Now let's bring out the next competitor.
Caden getting
in the
yet
gauntlet
another
match.
Elimination
this
in this gauntlet
is
match. And the next entrant. That music can mean only one thing. It's an SBW guy, Riley. Oh, that's right, he's not here. It's Steve Steele.
No, I'm here.
Steve's
just
coming
back
out of nowhere with a steel effect.
I'm here, I just got back.
Perfect timing, Steve Steele jamming out to his music after he caught Caden
one,
with a steel effect.
Two,
my
three.
God.
He out. Took Caden out so quick
get
that the music
get
didn't even
here.
Stop.
Listen to my fucking
you know,
music.
I've been hit by
out,
a steel effect, and let me tell you, actually, you know what? I have been hit by a steel effect, so I couldn't tell you how it goes.
And next coming out is Gunshot from
Wait,
Chaos Backyard
else?
Wrestling, now found on the Backyard Wrestling Community channel, and he caught him with a running forearm strike.
Tap out, you bastard.
Steve Steele, the current SBW Union champion.
Yes, he is. And ladies and gentlemen, I'm feuding with him, so I guess I'm going to have to take notes here.
Indeed. Riley giving us a little bit of information on the backstory of the SBW Union champion here. These two feuding with one another.
Let me tell you, Steve Steele is a very, very somewhat intelligent, somewhat dumbfounded. I don't know how to say it. He's one of the two, but he's very, very good at using people's moves against him. And I wouldn't be surprised
one,
if
two.
We see Steve Steele using
a jobber like
Gunshot's
this
finisher against him.
From that shithole from
it
South
wouldn't
Dakota
surprise
comes
me.
Here, thinks he can come here. I won a championship
but
in Indiana.
Then again,
hey,
Gunshot could
out
pull out the upset.
He just on said, did you hear what he said?
He calling out SBW.
But no, what? If what? I'm tempted to take myself, drive myself to Indiana and fight him before this show gets over with. I'm telling you.
Good sir, am not.
Well, shit. You never know what could happen here at Invading Indiana. We've already seen BWF and SBW
shit
competitors.
Let's talk about SBW compared to CBW.
These two going at it like a
like
pack
me
of wounded dogs.
You have killers like Nike. And you have killers like Riley Bates. And the only thing CBW has
giving it
is you.
they're all to each other, and I think this is like the best work we've ever seen Gunshot do.
Oh, what a big boot right to the side of the cheek to Gunshot. You know, Gunshot reminds me of a young Nate Diaz. That's a UFC person, if you didn't know. Who reminds me of a young Nate Diaz? We just need to know if he has enough stamina and relentlessness like Nate Diaz does.
Are you shit, huh? Huh?
How did he get... You gotta wonder, though, if Steve Steele's gonna be able to take him out. He took out Caden in quick fashion, but Gunshot's lasting a little bit longer.
Time for a move. Ladies and gentlemen, Gunshot picking up Steve Steele. What could he be looking for?
Oh, his shoulder's not down.
Two.
Oh, shit.
Steve Steele.
I can fix that.
Oh, the ref. Making sure that the shoulders are down here. Jesus. Nice call. And Steve Steele kicks out. You gotta wonder, that slight hesitation with his shoulder not being down could have affected the outcome of that, of this match here.
It may have, it may have.
And ladies and gentlemen, Steve Steele just going on the offensive maneuvers here.
This is what you want your champion to be.
Ladies and gentlemen, Steve Steele with a sleeper hold. There we go. Gunshot reversing with some elbows here. And now, face planting. Or I think that was the last shot. I could be the final shot. I don't know. Could be wrong. And now, ladies and gentlemen, Gunshot looking with a weird camel clutch there. Steele getting out of it. And now, ladies and gentlemen, Steele could be setting up for something here. Oh, what a big kick. What a big kick by Steve Steele. It could have been the gear grinder, but you never know.
This time, they hear us.
Oh, no.
These two are giving it their all, aren't they?
They are. And ladies and gentlemen, Steve Steele with a big splash, but Gunshot kicks out at two. And ladies and gentlemen, you know the referee is trying to help out here, making sure everyone is safe in this gauntlet match, which is very, very good.
Damn.
Definitely good job by the referee.
That is true. And ladies and gentlemen, both these men just delivered one hell of a double clothesline to each other. And now, ladies and gentlemen, Steele with a punch to Gunshot, and now Gunshot with a punch to Steele. Ladies and gentlemen, these two are going back and forth. Steele with a chop, Gunshot with some punches. Ladies and gentlemen, these are closed fists. They are not open palm strikes. These are closed fists. One of these things could knock them out. And please, dear love of God, do not bite someone's head off like Mike Tyson. And now Gunshot with a lapel lock. There we go. Good God. With a lapel lock to Steve Steele. And now Steve Steele. Oh, back body drop to Gunshot here tonight.
Do you quit?
Ladies and gentlemen, what a match. Could Steve Steele be looking for the Steel Effector gear grinder? And Steel Effect! He might not really have gotten all of it, but who knows?
Three.
A Steel Effect could put anybody out.
Coming out to the ring representing
UAW. And ladies and gentlemen, Steve Steele.
This is Nico.
Steve Steele beating Gunshot here. And ladies and gentlemen, Nyko Vibe coming out here and gonna be fighting Steve Steele in this gauntlet match.
You gotta wonder if Steve Steele's gonna be able to take Nyko Vibe down here.
All it takes, you know, a big man can fall. It just has to take by the right move. And ladies and gentlemen, Nyko Vibe picking Steve Steele up and an attitude adjustment.
No, it was an Ushigoroshi. Caught him right on the back of the knee.
One,
and
two,
what a forearm.
Three.
Ripcord Superman punch.
BW.
Oh, sorry.
This is
Nyko's powerhouse finisher.
And
the one, the only,
Oh, Nike. It was enough to take out. It was enough to take Steve Steele out.
And ladies and gentlemen, here comes a man that I have fought many, many times before. His name is Nike. And ladies and gentlemen, these two are going back and forth like a monkey's anus. Whoop, didn't mean to say that, but came back and forth. And ladies and gentlemen, Nike dropping him and now giving a big kick right to the back of Nike.
Laying in those shots to the back. You gotta wonder if these two have studied each other at all or not.
And ladies and gentlemen, Nike with a bat, oh, right across the stomach and now right across the spine. Oh, and a Nike with a sleeper hold here to Nike, and now Nike with some elbows to the gut of Nike Vibe. And ladies and gentlemen, Nike falling harder than a tree trunk on limber. And now Nike with a leg drop. Goes with a pin, and oh, a kick out at one. And now these two, Nike with some stiff fist shots right to the head.
These two going at each other. Nike getting the better of this transition. Now down on him, grinding his chin into his forehead. Nike with a running start, went for a big boot. Nike catches him with the Superman punch.
One.
And ladies and gentlemen, Nike could be down and out. And a kick out by Nike at one.
Nike, Nike, this is going to be a hard one to call.
Both ends, trust me. I have seen a match where there's both ends for names.
It's difficult, but wrenching in that ankle lock, that's Nike's favorite submission, having used it to win multiple matches. Nike able to fend him off.
I would believe that too. That ankle lock, if you snap the ankle, your opponent is done for. And as you can see, Nike might have snapped it, might have twisted it, but Nike was able to pop it back in by stomping it. And now, oh, what a big kick by Nike to Nike. This match could go either way. It could either have an SBW man, Nike, winning it, or UAW's own Nike Vibe.
Well, Nike is the final participant in the gauntlet match, the final entrant. Obviously, that's the best advantage coming in at the last spot.
And ladies and gentlemen, as you're saying,
Nike, I'm trying to figure out if that was like a weird figure four leg lock or what that was. But either way, Nike was able to fight out of it.
Yeah. And now, ladies and gentlemen, as you see, Nike holding on to his ankle. It could be popped, it could be twisted, it could be broken, it could be shattered, it could be many things. But it isn't looking good for Nike.
It is not looking good for Nike. Nike and Nike both down here, though. Now Nike focusing on that ankle once again.
And ladies and gentlemen, Nike standing up like he's the king of the mountain.
These two giving it their all to become the first ever Riot champion, and obviously they are not afraid to start a riot.
That is true. Ladies and gentlemen, I've been in the ring with Nike, and he is one that will not give up. Ask Mr. Soar. Ask Mike Everlast Bay. Ask Baynex. Ask myself. Ask Nightmare. Ask any one of those guys, and they will tell you that Nike does not give up. And he, I guarantee it, he will not give up in this match.
He may not give up, but Nike is sure making it difficult on him. Now working on the arm with an arm bar. Nike being meticulous and taking out individual limbs of Nike here. These two. Nike with a surprise attack, throwing up that barbed wire baseball bat and kicking it into the gut of Nike Vibe.
That's a clever offensive maneuver.
Nike not afraid to hold on to the barbed wire, now choking Nyko with that barbed wire baseball bat.
Nike is creative, but he is also sadistic.
He is definitely the most sadistic man on the SBW roster.
I wouldn't say most, but he is sadistic.
I mean, there's a nightmare, but you know. But Nike now laying into Nyko Vibe with those stiff baseball bat shots.
And I think Nike might have cut open the throat of Nyko Vibe. And if that does happen, we need an ER. We need some EMTs out there immediately, because Nyko probably won't have much chance of living after this match.
It definitely took the wind out of him. Could have crushed his esophagus. I'm not seeing any blood, so I don't think it cut him open. But he's definitely going to need to go to the ER after this one.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, Nike setting up Nyko Vibe. And now, ladies and gentlemen, Nike could be looking for... Oh, Whisper Snapper right to Nyko Vibe. That's a new move I haven't seen.
Definitely putting it all on the line here. Risking his body and Nyko's. Grabbing a Bang energy drink. Not sponsored, of course. Remember what Captain... Remember what Captain Law said? He said this is going to go out with a bang.
Don't mess with a fat person's stuff.
Oh, Nyko grabbing the drink. And now, ladies and gentlemen, could we be seeing a Hulk Hogan here? Is he going to get more energy out of the... Wait for it. Wait for it. Wait for it. Bang!
Nyko Vibe definitely trying to energize himself up with that bang.
Oh.
Got him up on his knee. Could he be looking for that same move that took out Steve Steele? Wait.
One! Two!
Oh, 10 saloon by Nyko Vibe. Oh! Nyko Vibe grabbing the leg. And ladies and gentlemen, Nyko hit Nyko Vibe with a 10 saloon, and Nyko now getting up. After that surprise.
Nyko coming off the stronger out of that little altercation there. Laying into the back, now grabbing that baseball bat once again.
Ladies and gentlemen, the bat is more a fan favorite than all these wrestlers here tonight.
Indeed, that bat is seeing a lot of action here tonight.
And what a move by Nyko to Nyko Vibe.
Obviously studying his Kurt Adams tapes, hitting him with that Dodunzo there.
Oh, a knee right to the back of the spine of Nyko Vibe. Ladies and Max, who do you think is going to win this match? Who are you rooting for?
Max, the Invading Indiana official mascot, joining us here at the commentary booth. But what is Nyko doing here? He's got that bat. Rolling Thunder! The bat to the chest! But that took just as much out of Nyko as it did Nyko.
One,
that's gonna hurt for both men here. Goes for the pin. And a big powerhouse kick out at two, and Nyko cannot believe it. I won't be surprised if these two go home in either an ambulance, either some wrist tape, something, or have stitches after the night.
These two are definitely brawling with each other. Giving each other their all here. Nyko catching Nyko with a kick. Nike's got the belt. Nyko's got the Riot Championship. What's he doing? Oh. Look to bash him over the head with it. Nyko with the Superman punch.
Oh, my God. What a kick.
One.
Nyko looking like he just had a seizure in midair.
Three.
Both men are down. The referee starting the count.
Four. Five.
And ladies and gentlemen, both these men moving, trying to get up before the count of 10.
And Nyko, the first to his feet.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, Nyko has the Riot Championship running after him. Oh, face first of gold, not the way Nyko wants it. But
Oh, Nyko getting cocky here, lifting up the Riot Championship, declaring himself champion, and the match hasn't even ended yet.
You can't be cocky around Nyko. Trust me, I've done that before, and I've got my ass whooped.
You know what they say, though. If you're the first to hold up the belt, you're the last to win it.
That is true.
Nyko now trading shots right to the back of the head and to the forehead of Nyko Vibe, and now to the back. Nyko preparing, getting a running start here. What's he looking to do?
I'm not done. Oh, what a clothesline, knocking the holy hell soul out of Nyko Vibe.
Nyko channeling his inner JBL there with that clothesline from hell.
And another one. Ladies and gentlemen, Nyko, I wouldn't be surprised if he brought out a bull and used that as a weapon or as a move here tonight.
Well, I mean, we've seen everything so far except the kitchen sink. We've seen sticks, drink cups, baseball bats, metal pipes, title belts. What's next?
Ladies and gentlemen, the bell rung, but I have no idea what's going on. And what a big knee.
I think our production team slipped up there.
What a big one, running knee, Daniel Bryan stomp by Nyko. This could be it. This could be over. Two. Over. And no. Nyko kicks out almost at three.
Barely getting that shoulder up. Come on. Nyko grabbing the baseball bat once again. And now lifting. Nyko Vibe. Nyko Vibe getting up to his feet and smacks the back of the bat over the back of the head. And now picking him up with the bat. And a side Russian leg sweep using the bat for extra leverage.
Two,
who knows, that could have also been an attempt saloon, but with the bat goes to the pin. Three, and ladies and gentlemen, Nyko wins it, bringing home the Riot Championship to SPW.
The anomaly known
as... I believe this is the first time we've had a South Dakota superstar win a UAW championship.
I think the ref was going to say Steve Steele, and I would have said those are two completely different human beings. But he changed it to Nyko.
The referee catching his slip up there, still in shock and all that, an SBW guy won the title. He almost announced the wrong SBW guy.
And ladies and gentlemen, what a match. And there you can see Nyko walking back there.
Looking to go home, looking to drive back to South Dakota.
And wait a minute, Nyko, face first into the vehicle.
Now grabbing his arm, what's he looking to do? He's got his arm trapped in the door.
Oh no. Children, don't watch.
That's
the
my style.
God!
What
the fuck are y'all doing in my car?
Captain Law asking him what he's doing in the car. Nyko teasing, shattering the glass.
Hey. Stop. Let me check your arm. I can feel the bone through the arm.
The bone is shattered of Nyko.
But I'm gonna call a medic for you, but I gotta strip
medic
of the Riot title. And since you...
I'm not nice anymore!
Captain Law stripping the UAW Riot Championship from Nyko.
On having a title, you're going to face gunshot right now, Falls Count Anywhere, for the Riot Championship. I'm booking.
And ladies and gentlemen, what a match just announced. So many things just happened. Nyko broke his arm. Nyko stripped of the Riot Championship, and we're going to have a match between Gunshot and Nyko Vibe for the Riot Championship right now.
Now it's time for the Riot Championship
Extreme
match.
Rules
Ring
Falls Count Anywhere match.
And these two going in for a collar and elbow tie-up. Nyko going around with the back with an arm, and now going to hold in a sleeper hold here. And now Gunshot trying to get out of it, and he does, going around the back with his own headlock.
I guess you could say this is another round of the gauntlet match, almost.
Yeah, it could be. And ladies and gentlemen, Nyko getting out of it. And a big kick to the gut by Nyko Vibe to Gunshot.
But I will say this, Nyko is the first ever inaugural Riot Champion, but unfortunately not holding the title for more than 2 minutes.
And ladies and gentlemen, Gunshot with these knees looking like Kenny Omega with wings.
I think that is the shortest title reign in UAW history. So Nike making history twice in one night.
That's true, and Gunshot with these punches right to the top of the dome of Nyko Vibe. And now Gunshot going in for a cross arm breaker, it looks like.
And Nyko with the wherewithal, using that arm bar himself, knowing how to get out of it, and turns it around into an ankle lock. And locking the other ankle. This is a weird ankle lock. I've never seen that style of ankle lock before, but it looks like it would get the job done.
You know what? Any submission, and I mean anything, if you can think of any way to hurt your opponent by a submission, whether it be a weird one, a new one, an old one, a textbook one, they will get the job done, I guarantee it. I've done one myself, but they will get the job done.
Indeed they will. I've never really stepped in a ring before, but Nyko Vibe grabbing the Riot title once again and pounds it off the skull of Gunshot. But I don't think he got all of that. That looked like quite the glancing blow.
Gunshot throwing something at Nyko, and now, oh, what a big kick.
Gunshot again with this unorthodox style, and it looked like a jawbreaker hitting the jaw right on the top of the shoulder blade. Wasn't a full stunner, though.
Well, what is Gunshot looking for here? Oh, wait, Nyko grabbing the leg. Could be looking for a calf pressure. No, gonna take the ankle and hold on to it. Again, a weird submission, but like I said, any submission will get the job done. I guarantee it.
Nyko Vibe with a history of working on them ankle locks.
Is that just cool? They hit me with a championship. Alright, Nyko Vibe, YT.
Gunshot tried to talk shit, but Nyko caught him with a dick punch for it. He mashed his potatoes like it was Thanksgiving dinner all over again, folks.
You know, somebody should have been in the crowd and said, hit him with the old dick twist, because that probably would have gotten the job done there.
Nyko Vibe with a steel pipe in his hand, the handle off that old golf club that kept him all bent over the chest of Kurt Adams earlier. But Nyko Vibe going for the favored bat of the night.
Ladies and gentlemen,
the barbed wire baseball bat.
Ladies and gentlemen, the bat of the night should have been like hockey. Just put it in for all three stars. Should be the main event. The bat should get its own match in here. And as of it looks like, the bat is being a match right here.
Nyko Vibe laying in to Gunshot with that bat.
Ladies and gentlemen, the bat.
Of UAW.
The bat being used in this Extreme Rules match. Anything will happen. And the bat looking to be a third member, trying to make this a triple threat. And I say that, Gunshot with a big kick and one more. For good measure, Nyko with a super kick right on the jaw.
Gunshot. So unorthodox, Nyko Vibe doesn't know how to really prepare him for anything. Ripcord Superman punch!
And ladies and gentlemen, Nyko flipping over Gunshot. Actually, yeah, gonna go
flipped
for an armbar, and Gunshot taps, ladies and gentlemen.
Here's your winner,
Gunshot
by submission.
Taps right away, and Nyko
and
doing what he couldn't in the Gauntlet match
champion,
and taking the Riot Championship.
Nyko Vibe, YT.
Nyko Vibe, the second ever UAW Riot Champion.
You know what?
Nyko Vibe, once again, a Grand Slam champion, holding all the titles in UAW.
I'm wrecking everybody, and I'm leaving. I don't care about anybody in my way. You get in my way, you're gone. Nobody will find you.
And ladies and gentlemen, Nyko Vibe with some strong words here at Invading Indiana. What a match that was. What a gauntlet match. What everything here tonight.
What devastation. But next up, it's teacher versus student. It's the main event in a Midnight Madness match for the BWF YouTube Championship. We're going to see Kurt Adams
is the Midnight
defending
Madness
the title
portion of the video
against Caden Ratana.
We have a BWF YouTube Championship match between the challenger, hailing from Huntington, Indiana, he is your CXG World Heavyweight Champion, CBW YouTube Champion, Caden fucking Ratana.
the Wolf of War, Caden Ratana. Only carrying out the CXG Championship, not the CBW YouTube Championship, because he's looking to add another YouTube title to his collection here tonight. Looking to walk away from this match is the Wolf of War with three championships.
And his opponent, the current
three belts
BWF Wolfie. YouTube Champion. You know him, you love him, he's hailing from South Dakota. This is Kurt Adams.
Ladies and gentlemen,
Adams.
Kurt Adams being in one Midnight Madness match against GM Phoenix. I watched it, not because I'm a fan of BWF, but I watched it, and it was one hell of a Midnight Madness match. Kurt Adams looking set, his record 2-0 here tonight.
It happened here.
Indeed he is.
That's how much it's worth. Because everybody knows we're putting on a damn best match.
And ladies and gentlemen, the caption for this match was student versus teacher. You gotta
but
wonder,
can the student overtake the master?
Or will the master teach a student his final lesson?
And the bell's underway, looking to go for a lockup, but Kurt not doing it.
I think Kurt Adams is hesitant. I think for the first time in a long time, I've seen Kurt Adams refusing to fight his opponent. And these two trying to lock arms, but no, Kurt Adams doesn't want it. And these two finally in a Roman knuckle lock here.
Caden hard into that gated fence there. Caden now has Kurt with a roll up. Kind of a DDT, dropped him on his head, didn't end up going in for the pin.
I'm thinking he was trying to trying to roll him off or go for a Impaler DDT, but you never know. It is a Midnight Madness match, so it is kind of hard to see what's going on.
One.
Kurt with a quick pin there, only a one count, side headlock. Technical wrestling on show.
And Caden
able to slip out.
And ladies and gentlemen, I have seen the resume of Caden Ratana. He likes to be called effing, but I'm not going to say it. Because I respect him, but I'm not, what do you want to call it, close to him. But Caden, I've seen Caden's resume. It fits the book to be in an SBW superstar anywhere else, BWF, you name it. And I've also seen Kurt Adams' resume. That goes along with Caden's. And these two are like copycats here.
And Caden throwing Kurt into that gated fence and then catching him with a rear naked choke, but Kurt catches him with a stunner on the down end.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, you gotta wonder though if Caden will be able to put his master away here tonight, and you also gotta wonder if Kurt Adams will be able to put away the student, a man that he respects. Both of them respect each other.
Caden catching him with an enziguri. Sorry to cut you off, but again, Respect is out the window for this on a Shining Wizard.
I was actually going to say it's a Gary and a Shining Wizard there. But no, it's all right. Caden setting up Kurt Adams. And now, ladies and gentlemen, these two go into a collarable tie-up. No. Actually, yeah, they're still going into a collarable tie-up. Caden just holding it on for a little bit longer. And now, kicking Kurt Adams. And now, what a knee. What
Deadeye V-trigger. You heard
Deadeye,
him.
My God, what a super kick.
I gave you plenty of warnings.
You heard him call out Captain Law there, hitting him with the Deadeye V-trigger.
I told you.
Obviously, Captain Law and Kurt Adams both Caden's mentors. But Kurt Adams, the superior of the two mentors here, having been the one that found Caden.
And ladies and gentlemen, Kurt Adams calling Caden a side project. You gotta think, if that goes with Caden here, and if that's going in his mind at all, if he can either put Kurt Adams away here or not.
You also got to wonder, though, if Kurt's going to be able to put his side project away. You got to wonder, is Kurt going to be able to do what needs to be done to finish
in the same off way? This boy? The same way goes with Kane and all a shining wizard.
A kick just across the bottom of the chin. Crumpled Kurt Adams. Again, you've got to wonder if Caden is kind of in Kurt's mind. And another Shining Wizard!
Ladies and gentlemen, these Shining Wizards are more powerful than the basketball team.
Caden learned from Kurt Adams, but Kurt's back up and stomps Caden's head into the ground.
What a move by Kurt Adams. Rolling elbow drop. Two, Caden and Tana by Kurt Adams, but a kick out at two by Caden, and Caden just catching Kurt Adams on the side with a kick, and now these two going back and forth. Caden picking up Kurt right into the fence, and now Kurt Adams giving Caden his own receipt and a big punch, but these two going all over the place here in this match.
This is a Midnight Madness match, and they are sure giving it the madness it has earned. And Caden with a big spinning kick there, catching Kurt in the gut, but I don't think he got all of it because Kurt's still moving.
You cannot judge any of these men. Cannot judge both these men because these two will make you judge themselves.
They will definitely make you hurt. And you gotta wonder though, these two have had multiple matches throughout the night with not only each other, but with everybody else. You got to wonder if that's going to affect him. Caden might have been looking to drop Kurt onto that stump, but Kurt able to slip through just enough so Caden couldn't do it, but Caden turned it around into a punch.
Ladies and gentlemen, Caden thinking here. And ladies and gentlemen, Kurt Adams looking all pissed as hell, and these two going around each other, circling. And now, cameraman zooming in. Kurt Adams is going to try to go for a stunner. No, super kick by Kurt Adams. The king. And now again, but a big boon. Caden running himself in there.
I think that was more a Claymore kick.
Yeah, could have been. But again, this Midnight Madness match have an effect on us for commentating.
Midnight Madness for sure. The ground is slippery with that fresh morning dew. This Indiana soil gets cold and wet at night. Now Kurt and Caden back up on each other's feet. Kurt spinning Caden around.
And a sling blade. That's a new move by Kurt Adams I have never seen before. These two putting out new moves so fast that if you tried to make pancakes, would never compete against these two.
These two are definitely working on each other now. Kurt's inhibitions of going after Caden obviously out the window. These two giving it their all. Caden back to his feet, though, drives the knee right into the gut of Kurt.
Ladies and gentlemen, Caden punching Kurt Adams. And now, could we be seeing some sign of sympathy here? Wait, no. Go, Kurt Adams dropping Caden and some kicks right to the back and flipping Caden over here. And I'm going to try and go with a foot press for a pin, and Caden kicks out. Now these two are just going all over the place. Oh, Caden with a low blow to Kurt Adams. And now could we be seeing the Wolf's Journey? No. Kurt Adams tripping Caden up, and I'm going to go for a finger four here tonight. And Caden,
finger four leg lock. Caden's got to roll over onto his stomach to reverse the pressure. If he can do that, that would reverse the submission onto Kurt Adams.
But you know, Caden, there's nothing here to break it up. There's no ropes, no nothing. If Caden doesn't get out of this, and he got out.
Was able to roll through out of it, but Kurt with a big kick now driving his legs and those shots into Caden. And now he's got Caden up on his shoulders.
Could we be seeing Pyramid Buster? goes for the pin. 1, 2, and a kick out at 2. And Kurt Adams can't believe it.
Kurt obviously wondering what he's got to do to put away his side project, obviously building the project too well.
This is like Frankenstein's monster. You have to destroy what you've created, and that's what Kurt Adams is trying to do here tonight.
Kurt Adams back into the darkness here.
He's trying to figure out how to put him away.
I tried telling him I couldn't do this. I swear I couldn't make a claim of this. He's become more than just a side project. He's become everything I've ever imagined my career would be. It's weird.
Kurt, unsure what to do, and Caden kicking his head into the steel grated fence.
My God, we might have to get some EMTs out here. Kurt Adams could have a concussion.
That was a hell of a kick. Going low again. I don't think Kurt's going to be able to have children after this. But you got to wonder if Caden holds any sympathy left for Kurt, or if Kurt's nothing to him now. Does he think he's passed up his own maker?
You don't. I don't know. I'll tell you this. If Caden does come to SBW, something's coming for him.
I know, but I have to.
Caden telling Kurt he's doing it because he has to.
Doc, write me. Lightning has to boss Doc around until Doc.
I think if Caden wanted to put away Kurt Adams right here, right now, he has to hit him with the Wolf's Journey and end it 1, 2, 3. He can't be wasting time like this. Kurt Adams kicks up. Caden doesn't see it. Oh, what a
claymore
by Kurt Adams to Caden Ratana here tonight.
Show me what you are.
A big claymore in that. Caden talking shit gave enough time to Kurt to fire him up.
And ladies and gentlemen, Kurt Adams going more angrier than a Karen on a Wednesday night.
He's MMA. He's pulling out some MMA moves there, locking him in with the punches.
Locking him in with the front mount here. And ladies and gentlemen, oh God, Kurt Adams could be looking for that tombstone. But Caden reversing it here.
What are they doing now? Caden's grabbing him.
Could be looking for a suplex. No.
Kurt blocking it. Caden rolling over on top of Kurt, though. Went for a pin, but didn't hold Kurt down enough to even get a one count. These two are all over the place here tonight.
No. Show this.
You've got to wonder if this is going to take a toll on their relationship after the match.
Ladies and gentlemen, this isn't for the faint of heart.
He's got him. Wolf's Journey
by Caden effing Ratana. I'll say it one time here.
1, 2.
And ladies and gentlemen, the student beating the teacher here tonight.
WWF YouTube champion, the CXG owner and operator, Caden fucking Ratana.
Obviously an emotional moment for Caden. The student becoming the master here tonight. And you gotta think there's still some love there. Caden picking up his fallen mentor.
And
they hug it out.
Nice moment here, ladies and gentlemen. Very good. Both these two, close friends, close pals. But at the end of the day, it was never about. Oh.
Caden's saying he's not done with him yet.
It's your winner. BWF YouTube Wrestling Champ. Brought it out of. Retirement? No. Quit walking. Quit doing it.
I'm kidding.
So, you remember that day, you messaged me. We learned, show me about those two. Right?
Yeah.
Remember when you found me? When you said I was good. One of the best in the group. Remember that? And they gave me an option. I took, you told me go do this. I did it. I did what you probably didn't think I could. Look, I take that back. You knew I could do it, but I did
it. I see you as more than just a backyard wrestling friend. I see you as more than just someone I met online. I see you as someone that I consider family, someone that I see so much of myself in, and I hope to God in a couple years you end up in the same place I did, and that's at the top of the rung, invading the best of the best, fighting the best of them, the best, proving why you are best.
What a magical moment between these two.
Yes, it is.
Student taking the master out.
Now these two giving a fist bump, and now, ladies and gentlemen, Kurt Adams raising the hand of Caden Ratana.
Because of Dale, because of Chris. I don't care how hard about it anymore. Because of all three of you. You made me mentally help me, physically. You guys help me with everything. I text you when I'm down. Sometimes you're saying dead fire charge. I text you when I'm down. I need you for everything. I need you for everything.
Congrats, brother. Congratulations,
man. It's the top of a company that we all want. A title that we've seen on many pay-per-views. That we didn't think we'd even touch. But somebody that we never thought we'd face or touch. I did it. I'm in BWS. Gunshot, get over here. I'm in BWS. I want you in there too.
You ain't gonna show Gunny no love?
Gunny deserves the most love, man. Come on.
Caden, giving love to everyone, sharing this sentimental moment with everyone. Caden, telling everybody he wants them all in BWF together.
That is... that is some heartbreaking stuff, and that is some stuff that... Oh! What?!
Bro. Why?
See? No.
What a dick!
This ain't about you.
Why?
You came to my company. You came to my company.
Everyone in shock
here. You took my world championship, and I took that back from you. And now you think that just because you're at the BWF level, that you're on the top of the mountain, that you're better than me. And I can see it in your eyes. Every time you looked at me, I saw it in your eyes, that you thought you were better. So sure, you may be the champion of your own goddamn company. Congratulations, I can do that too. But this is the championship of a company that's better than you, Gunny, or anyone else will ever be. And I am bound and fucking determined to take the shit back from you.
Ladies and gentlemen, what are we witnessing here?
I'm at a loss for words. Captain Law just ruining what is supposed to be Caden's special moment, but... I guess this is... is that how this is going to end?
It can't end like this.
Apparently, it's going to... So thank you all for watching, and... I'm speechless.